Peace be unto you, Peter.
Clarence, unto you be peace.
Peace be unto all of you.
Unto you be peace.
Clarence, I thought I told you.
Good to see you too, brother.
What do you need?
Well, truthfully, I thought I might become the 13th apostle. Iscariot.
Thomas, this is your brother I hate a lot.
He looks exactly like you, but nothing like you at the same time.
I'm older.
By 10 minutes.
Still older.
Anyway, if you would all stop giggling so much, you might come to the realization that it requires many of us to spread the gospel of the Messiah. Now, who better than me? I mean, I've got the cobblestones on lock. I think I know what it takes.
Yes. You know what it takes. But you do not possess what it takes, which is selflessness, generosity, placing others' needs before your own.
Did you put mother's needs before your own? Don't tell me I'm a bad person. Just playing the cards I was dealt.
You don't even believe in the Immaculate Conception.
No, I didn't say I didn't believe in it. I said it's a bit far-fetched.
Blasphemy!
I don't mean to disrespect, Peter.
That's just the thing, Clarence. You're disrespectful. That reason alone, you could never be an apostle. It's apostle, by the way, not apostle.
Okay, Thomas, why don't we let Jesus decide? What time does he get home?
That is not the way it works, dear brother.
Look, if this man wanted to change everyone's perception of him, he would do something like free those slave gladiators from Asher the Torturer. Of course, he will be killed, but at least we'll know he is not all about himself.
Would you do it? Who have you freed? You would pass judgment on this man and you don't even know him.
Peter, that is not what I was saying.
That is precisely what you are saying.
How is that what I was
saying? Well, why don't you explain it to me?
I've already explained it. I said if he wants to become a 13th apostle, he should do something like free those slave gladiators from Asher the Torturer.
It's here. Let's bring it down to here.
Clarence.